Alright, I'm just getting started. We gotta do some togging again, black fishing again. A different spot. Honestly, I don't even know where we at, so I wouldn't bother commenting. Here we go. Just gonna figure out where they are, which is always the hardest part. Anyway, I got delayed because my former college called me and asked me all these stupid questions and questionnaires. Oh, I got whacked. Here we go. Whack me again. They're small. They're not big. So anyway, Aunt Temple called me just to do some questions and meanwhile I'm getting whacked by a small fish. Oh yeah, I got one. Oh yeah. Oh man, that's a good one. Is that a good one? Oh, it's a small one. That's a 14er. That's a 14. Yep. Look how fat these fish are though. Oh my God. Look at this. Look how fat this fish is. That's ridiculous, dude. He just whacked the hell out of me. Cool, man. That's really cool. Oh my. I can't believe how hard these 14-inch fish, they pull very hard. They fight like a Mack truck, man. Every single fish I caught this fall were, oh my God, they're just plump. They're healthy, they're not pressured, and it just means that, you know, no one's targeting them. I like to target them just for fun. I like to get one for dinner, you know, but I don't need a lot. Then comes the open season. These jetties are going to be lined with people. So there's no way in hell you're going to catch these pressured fish. Because what happens is that they get caught and then they get released. And they won't bite for a while, you know, because they have a freaking hole in their mouth. I see on Facebook talking to Sea Money Fishing. And I legit get a hit. I wasn't even paying attention. I got a hit. Anyway, then we got bait fish. But I don't see any bait fish. Just not the epitome of black fishing. Gotta get rid of some of the line because, you know, sometimes the lines are gonna chafe so much that you're gonna lose fish. So, and keep this because you wanna keep this place as fresh as possible. Anyway, let's go back to my bag. Let's grab. So, the only thing that irks me the most is losing so much gear. Losing so much gear to these damn fish. I mean, they're fun and all, but you know, the gear, the money, it stacks up. Then you have bait on top of it. Then you have food on top of it. And then you have exhaustion on top of it. And then you have, oh man, my arm hurts on top of it. But, all in all, that's fishing for you. You know? I got the whole place to myself, too. I don't plan on seeing any more people today. To get to some of the best fishing, no one has to be around. And then you don't have to worry about getting mugged. You don't have to worry about getting spot burned. You don't have to worry about people throwing on top of you. And you don't have to worry about idiots throwing 5-ounce sinkers with poppers on there and, you know, hooking you with a freaking single hook. But that's just me, you know. All right, let's get back into this. I've done my rant. You know, it's peaceful, you know. I like the peace. Oh. No, oh, man, got me in a rock. Damn, it got me in a rock. You butt. You. Oh, man. Don't think they're big. They're not hitting like big fish. If you're getting these big fish, if you're getting these, you know, taps, like really, you know, 10 taps, they're small fish. If you're getting the hits like a tap and a pump, if you're getting a hit and it's a tap and a pull, that's a pretty big fish. It's a heavy fish. These fish are not, they don't look too big for me because they're just tapping and tapping. I mean, they're down there. Every freaking rig I lose is like a dollar out of my pocket. It's so costly, dude. There's a dolphin. Oh, cool! There's three of them. Wow, I've never seen them these close. Look at that, it's jumping out of the water. Just leaping out of the water. That is awesome. There's one in front of me. There's two more. And I got a hit. Just got whacked. No, fishing sucks, you know. I just came out here to watch dolphins leap, you know. Can't watch dolphins leap. Damn, I'm getting lots of small ones. A lot of small hits. I'm using big hook, that's why. So I'm not really hooking these fish. All I am is hooking these freaking rocks. That's all I'm doing. I keep thinking, you know, they're not biting, so I can have some time to, you know, cut some bait and stuff. But they keep biting when I'm not holding it. Little buggers, man. They're always biting when I'm not paying attention. I legit missed like three hits because like I wasn't paying attention. Either I was on my phone, replying to a message, seeing who's calling me, and well. All that happened so quick. Didn't have time to freaking set the hook. Starting off slow, we started off really quick and then we went back to being really slow. So 2 ounce sinker, any round like sinker, just gonna make these underhand loops, you know. And we have our snout hooks that I tied last night, 3 aughts. And a half a crab. So we don't loot, so we, you know, stick. So you don't have any bait stealers. Other buttholes are just way too quick. I got hit right away, see? There we go. Yeah. Small one though. Oh, you son of a ass. He got caught. He got caught down here. See, he got caught. Got caught on muscle beds. There we go. And he's a small one. Look at that. He's a 14 incher. Look how fat these fish are though. It's ridiculous. This is a 14 inch fish and he is going back. Beautiful 14 inch fish. Have fun. Oh yeah! Small ones though. Ugh. Wow. So many small ones here. Ugh. Easy there. again, these small fish, look how fat these fish are, man. It's ridiculous. These fish are so healthy. Like, I don't even want to damage them. So, oh my god, lots of small hits, lots of hits, but I'm pretty sure they're all small. I'm not hooking them. My hook is big. We're looking for the big fish with these big hooks. Got hit already, dude. See? See? On, son! On, son! It's all small. Look how pale this fish is. You see how pale this fish is? Really opaque. This fish came from the ocean. Because it's so white. It's so gray. It's so gray. But that's a fish. Oh, that's a fish for 2 years. You know? I like it, you know? I really do. I really like fighting these fish. Once in a while, you get something really big. You get something big. And, you know, it pays off. But, you know, this type of fishing is all by chance. You get lucky if you get a bigger one. Someone keeps texting me. Every time I get on my phone, I get a hit. Oh yeah! See, every time I put it down, I get a small fish. Wow, this is about 14. 13 and a half, 14. But they are here and with sass. That was a loud ass belly flop. Jeez, man. Tranquil as a river, but submerged. They are, these tog are playing me crazy. When I ask for more, you sither poo, the rage of war. So pack up, you're out of rigs. How could I catch these fish without rigs? Da 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 da. Love Mulan. Oh, there we go. Oh, my fault. Damn it. There's fish in here. But, like always, the smalls invaded. The smalls will invade. If we don't get any more hits, I'm gonna move. I'm gonna make a move. I got a hit, got a hit. Yeah, there we go. Oh no. My reel locked up on me. Oh no. My reel locked up on me. All right, I can't do this. I broke the oscillation on this reel, so it's not oscillating right. Oh, man. That is just a bummer to my day. I'm back with it again, but I borrowed one of my dad's reels, spare spools he had, and it has 40-pound braid on it, and to me, braid, I don't like using braid. I'm not familiar using braid for blackfish, but this is the only thing I can do. I can't do anything else. Let me make sure our drag is set appropriately before we throw. And braid, I'm really unfamiliar using braid. Unfamiliar using braid. It's not my liking. Let's see if I can catch a fish on braid. Blackfish on braid. The mono, if I was using mono, I'd be more comfortable because, you know, it could take the beating. See, it could take a beating. Fish is this? It can take a beating. Man, that's gonna be close, dude. That's gonna be a close fish. That's gonna be a close fish. That's gonna be close. Let's try it. Only has to need be 15. If it's 15, oh man, this is gonna be on the money if it is 15. The tape. Yeah, 15, just over 15. 15 and a quarter. All right, first fish on the braid. I'm so not used to using. I catch a keeper 15 and a half. Isn't that great? I don't know how to use this braid for blackfish. I don't like using braid. I don't like using braid for blackfish. It feels better. I mean, I ain't gonna lie, I feel that hits much better, but you know, I'm very, very cautious of the line getting cut off by the rocks. You know, there's so much sharp edges. And that was the only problem I had, since I'm so far up on the rocks, I'm gonna be touching the rocks the whole time. You know, I'm gonna be rubbing on that rock, right? That's just, you know, just peeking out. That was the only problem I had. That's why I use mono, you know, have better abrasion resistance. I got another hit too. Talking about with braid line shapes really quickly, and there's no resistance to, you know, prevent you from getting cut off. So that has to get off. I'm gonna leave it here and clean it up later, and that comes off as well. Sinker comes off as well, and leave it there, and we'll clean it up later. And we gotta go back and get going. Now the water got a little bit churned up because the incoming tide, the current is ripping now. That 1 hour of, you know, 1 hour after dead low, it's that slack, that slow time. And then now it's like 1 o'clock, 1:30. Dead low was at 12 o'clock today, and I was getting a hit when it was slack. Technically, I do very well during the slack incoming and the slack outgoing. Yep, so say this one, dead low was posted at 12 o'clock. I was doing good 12 to 1 o'clock. He's maybe under. Wow, I'm gonna measure this just in case, just for fun, because this is a long fish. This fish, 14 and a half. Look how fat this fish is, you know? These fish, you know, they really run me. Give me a good fight. Look how fat that fish is, you know? Let's just get this going. I'm gonna throw the other side because the other side just, there's too many freaking, it's just too low. But look at that. That is a beautiful 14 and a half inch fish. All right, let's get it going. So we have, this is my dad's. My dad's really a Shimano freak. So this, yeah. Small ones. Small ones. I didn't get to finish what I was saying. Ah, don't do that because you hurt yourself. It's damn slippery fish. So I broke the main gear of that old Penn reel that you saw me using in the beginning of the video. Coincidentally enough, 10 years ago it broke the same way. I got it fixed, I got it repaired, put it out of commission for a good number of years, and brought it back out for the past 2 years. As of this moment, it is fixed again, so we'll be seeing a lot more of that reel in future videos.